Hi, E3 Kids. Pastor Linda here. I am here to just give you the lesson for today. And so today's story, we are looking at two people. It was a husband and a wife. Their name was Ananias and Sapphira. Okay? So before we start, so welcome everyone. I hope you are doing very well today. So we're going to pray before we start. So let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you, oh God, for our lesson today. I thank you, Lord, for each and every one of the boys and girls who are listening to me today. We ask you that, Lord, you teach us about what you want us to learn from Ananias and Sapphira. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so this story is found in Acts chapter 5. Verse 1 to 11. Okay, so if you have your Bible or your parents, maybe later on they can be able to read this story for you from Acts chapter 5, verse 1 to 5. So, verse 1 to 11. So, I'm not going to read the story, I'm just going to just tell it to you. Okay, so this was the time when Jesus had rose up from the dead and he had gone up to heaven. And at that very time, the church had just started. So that was the very, very first church, okay? So you guys are part of E3 Church. And years and years ago, there was the first church, okay? And that was in Israel. So this very, very first church, they did almost the same things that we do. They would come together, they would sing, they would worship God. You know, and then somebody would preach, you know, one of the leaders would preach and or teach about the Bible. The kids would come in. I mean, they were just having fun like everybody else, you know. And like, you know, every Sundays we would collect the offering, right, at E3 Church. And we still do collect even online. And so that's what was happening at this time. So they were collecting the offering. And so, you know, when you are bringing your offering, you bring, you know, what you want to bring, what you have decided as a family. And so Ananias and Sapphira, you know, came to church that day, but Ananias came in first, Sapphira stayed behind. And Ananias came in and, you know, in his heart, he had the offering in his hands. But he was like, you know, he's not going to give everything. He was just going to give, you know, just part of it, okay? So he decided to put in this part offering in the offering basket. And then Peter asked him, you know, did you give everything that you were supposed to give? Now, guess what? He should have been honest and said, well, actually, no. I only gave part. But do you know what he did? He said, oh yes, I gave everything. I sold what I needed to sell and I gave everything to God. And you know what? You know, God saw what was in his heart, that his heart was not right. And so right there and then, you know, something bad happened to Ananias, you know, and he just fell right there. He fell right there. And immediately he fell, his wife, Sapphira, who was behind him, came over. And Peter, the apostle Peter, was asking her, you know, hey, Sapphira, did you and Ananias give everything that you were supposed to give? And Sapphira, you know, even her, oh, I wish she had been honest, right? But she wasn't honest. She lied to Peter and said, oh no, oh yes, we gave everything, we gave everything. And Peter, you know, just rebuked her and said, that is not what you're supposed to do. You know, why are you lying? You're not lying to me, you are lying to God himself. And so what happened to Ananias happened to Sapphira as well, right there and then. So, you know, what are we learning from this story? What do we learn? One thing that we learn from this story is that God knows what's in our heart, okay? God knows what's in our heart. And he wants us to be honest, you know, not only with him, but with others as well, right? So if boys and girls at home, if your parents come home and they ask you, you know, did you eat the cupcake that I told you not to eat? And you know you ate the cupcake, what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to tell your parents, yes, I did, and I am sorry. Don't be like Ananias and Sapphira, because they lied, okay? They lied, but they forgot that God sees what's in our heart. God knows everything about us, okay? God knows everything about us. Now, I know each and every one of you boys and girls, you are good boys and girls. I know that you know that Jesus is watching our hearts, and I know that you are very, very honest. You are always listening to your parents, and you always tell the truth, even if it's hard, right? And if you are having a hard time telling the truth, you know what you can do? I want you to pray right now. Just ask Jesus, Lord, help me to say the truth, because I know you know what is in my heart. Okay? So that's the lesson today. The lesson really is about that God is watching over each one of us, and he knows everything about us. But not only that, God loves us. God loves us, okay? God loves you. God loves me. God loves each and every one of us. So I want you this week, boys and girls, this week, I want you to be extra, extra, extra aware that God is watching over you, and he knows what's in your heart. And if you find yourself in a situation where you have to be honest, guess what? The best is to be honest, okay? The best is to be honest. All right, so we are not going to have an activity, you know, today, but I do have a little game, you know, for you. And for those of you who are older, if you are maybe 9 and above or 10 and above, those of you who are 10 years and above, I did send something to your parents. It's just a little puzzle. All you need to do is unscramble the words, okay? So the words, they are letters, but each of those has, you know, words from this story, okay? So what I would suggest for you to do is to actually read the story if you can, or have your parents read the story for you, and then I want you to do that puzzle, okay? Write out what are the names, what are the things that are going to appear on that little puzzle. So just ask your parents, okay? Ask your parents, I sent them something, okay? And if your parents don't have access to us, if your parents don't have access to us, we want you to just tell your parents to email info@e3church.org. That's info, I-N-F-O, at e3church.org. And all they need to do is just ask us and say, we need the puzzle for the Sunday lesson, okay? All right, so before you head out, before you do anything, first, I want you to play this game. And then after that, if you are 10 years or 9 years and above, if you can read, you can do this puzzle. Your parents have it, so why don't you do that and enjoy yourself? So before we go, I'm going to pray, okay? Before I go, I'm going to pray. And then after I pray, we're going to go straight into that game, all right? Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for the lesson we have learned today. Thank you that you are watching over us. Thank you that you know everything that is in our heart. And Lord, I want to pray that you will help us to be honest this week, honest with one another, honest with even our parents, our teachers. Help us, help the boys and girls, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's head into that game.
Welcome to the Books of the Bible game, where you try to decide whether a book from the Bible is in the Old Testament or the New Testament. Let's give the Books of the Bible wheel a spin. The first book is the Book of Ruth. If you think the Book of Ruth is in the Old Testament, then clap your hands. If you think the Book of Ruth is in the New Testament, then make a bird noise. If you were clapping your hands, then you were right. The Book of Ruth is in the Old Testament. Let's give the Books of the Bible wheel another spin. It looks like this time the wheel landed on 1 and 2 Timothy. If you think these books are in the Old Testament, wiggle your nose. If you think they're in the New Testament, pull on your ear. If you're pulling on your ear, then you're right. The books of 1 and 2 Timothy are in the New Testament. Let's spin the wheel again. This time, the books of the Bible wheel landed on the book of Judges. If you think the book of Judges is in the Old Testament, then stick out your tongue. If you think the book of Judges is in the New Testament, then scratch your head. If you were sticking out your tongue, then you were right this time. Judges is in the Old Testament. Let's see what book the wheel lands on next. It looks like this time, it's the book of Proverbs. If you think the book of Proverbs is an Old Testament book, then make a funny face. If you think it's a New Testament book, then rub your belly. If you were making a funny face, then you're right. The book of Proverbs is in the Old Testament. Let's spin the wheel one more time. The last book that the books of the Bible wheel landed on is Hebrews. If you think Hebrews is in the Old Testament, touch your nose. If you think the book of Hebrews is in the New Testament, roar like a lion. If you roared like a lion, then you are correct. The book of Hebrews is in the New Testament. Thanks for playing the Books of the Bible game. Come and play again soon.